Hi and welcome to the Enquendor Guitars Workshop. My name is Daniel and in this video I'm putting all these parts on the two guitars I've been working on for the last couple of weeks. So by the end of this episode I should have two playable guitars. I've got all my parts, or almost all my parts, in to finish these two guitars. I'm still waiting on one set of Fishman pickups and that should arrive tomorrow or the day after, so hopefully before this video goes live, and I have indeed two playable guitars at the end of this video. But yeah, one guitar is going to get all Grom hardware while the other is going to get all Black hardware. They're twin guitars, but they're still very different. These assembly videos can be a bit boring in my opinion, so this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to assemble these two guitars and give you some general tips and tricks and some pointers, but for the very important or the more in-depth stuff, I'm going to make some separate tutorials. For example, for placing and aligning the Spurzel tuners and using a specialized tool to locate the locating pin on these tuners. That can be tricky sometimes, so I'm going to make a separate tutorial about that. And I'm also planning to do a separate tutorial on wiring Fishman pickups in a two volume and two push-pull tone configuration. So yeah, that will be in a separate video, but I will give you some pointers during this video. So yeah, let's start assembling these two guitars, and I start with the bridge and the string ferrules on the back of the guitars. So first off, the string ferrules, and what I like to do is first measure and check the depth, if my holes are deep enough. And if that's the case, I'm going to use my stepper drill to clean any finish that got into the holes. And I'm going to do this just by hand, just to remove some of the finish. Yeah, it should fit. Always check if that little flange on your string ferrule fits. And it does. And you can buy specialized tools to insert these string ferrules. Well, what I like to use is just a 6mm dowel that fits inside the string ferrule. And remove these from the guitar body. And then use a little hammer to gently tap it in. Mounting the bridge is very straightforward. I've got my hip shield bridges and I've already drilled in all the holes while I was making the body, so very straightforward. Just take the bridge apart and be careful not to lose any spring or little screw. Just take it apart because the mounting holes are underneath the saddles, and use the supplied screws. One little tip, use good quality and very good fitting screwdrivers on these screws. Screws supplied with hardware are usually very soft and it's very easy to damage them, especially these black painted screws. I want to keep the paint on them, so I'm going to make sure I have the correct screwdriver. And if it's hard to get the screws, to drive the screws into the wood, I don't recommend using a cordless drill or something, because it will damage your screw, but just use a bit of wax on your screw and it should be fairly easy to do. We'll be right back.
So on to the tuners, and I've did a little preparation already. I made sure everything is aligned, and I've got this little tool from Spurzel that helps me with drilling the hole needed for the small little guide pin on these Spurzel tuners. That's always a bit tricky, but they have a tool to help you align your tuners and to drill that little hole. And I'm going to make a separate video on how to use this tool and how to properly align all your tuners. And always use proper fitting tools on your hardware, like with a screwdriver. I use an 11 millimeter socket that fits perfectly for these bushes. So the tuners are in, and that little tool really helps. So if you want to know more, look out for an upcoming video specifically on that tool and how to use it to drill these holes for the tuners.
Before I'm putting in the pickups and put on two strings to align the pickups, I'm going to polish the frets one last time. I'm very sorry for all those time lapses. Yeah, we have a lot of ground to cover in this episode, and I don't want this to be an episode of over an hour long. So yeah, a lot of time lapses. If you have any questions, put them in the comment section down below, and I do my best to answer them. After putting in the electronics, I put the rest of the strings on, straightened the neck, and did a very basic setup. I always do a very basic setup here in the shed just to make sure it's tuned and I can play it a little, and then I take it inside, hang it on the wall for a couple of days, play it just a little until everything has set itself, because it's the first time this guitar is under tension, and then do a final setup. And I do that in the office because I have a much better tuner there than I have here in the shed. So let's continue by putting some knobs on, of course the strap buttons, and put the cover plates back on, and then this guitar should be playable, and I'll finish the other one. In the video where I drilled the holes for the control knobs, I mentioned to always have your hardware present and check the diameter of your potentiometers, because the shaft diameter can vary. There are usually two diameters, 9.5, 9.6, I believe, and 8 millimeters. I was still waiting on the second set of Fishman pickups, and the set I had at that time had 9.6 millimeter shafts, but unfortunately the set I was waiting for had a delivery time of yet another 5 weeks almost, so it wouldn't be here in time for this build. So the guys at Tolman were kind enough to send me a different set, and they sent me this Tosin Abassi signature set, also Fishman Fluence pickups. But unfortunately the pots that come with this set have a smaller shaft. It has an 8 millimeter shaft. If you have modded guitars, you might have come across the same problem, that the guitar body has 10 millimeter holes and the pots supplied with a pickup set, for example, have 8 millimeter holes, 8 millimeter shafts to be exact. Well, there's a quite easy solution. I found this tube, the plastic tube with an outer diameter of 10 millimeters and a wall thickness of 1 millimeter, leaving a hole of exactly 8 millimeters. I've got some very small rings. I can just put them over the shaft, insert the pot, and it's nice and snug in the hole. We'll be right back.
one of the last steps to do is sign the back of the cover plate. Right, and let's close her up. And here we go, two guitars ready to rock. I think they turned out absolutely stunning. And yeah, let me know in the comment section down below what you think of these guitars. This is also somewhat the end of this series. Like I said, upcoming video will be a tutorial on how to align the tuners using the Spurzel tuner tool I showed in this video. And the video afterwards will be a tutorial on how to wire these Fishman pickups. I hope you liked this series, and if you did, yeah, let me know also in the comment section down below. And by hitting that like button, I really appreciate your comments and your support. In the meantime, I'm going to prepare for the Great Guitar Build-Off. Yes, I am participating in this year's edition of the Build-Off, and I'm very excited. I've got a build planned, and I've got to do some preparations, and I'm planning to make 6 videos, like stated in the rules, 6 15-minute edited videos of the entire build. So yeah, if you want to follow along, make sure you are subscribed to my channel and you've hit that notification bell so you get notified when I upload something new. So yeah, keep an eye out for the 2 tutorials that are coming up the coming 2 weeks, and of course the Great Guitar Build following straight after. For the end of this video, I'm going to try these 2 guitars out. I'm going to take them inside to my office or studio and noodle around a bit. So if you're interested in hearing these 2 guitars, yeah, keep watching. And otherwise, I hope to see you all in the next video. But until then, have a nice week. So I'm in the office, and yeah, let's see if we can get some tones from this guitar. I'm using my Boscatena 50 on the 25 watt setting, and everything is centered. So gain, bass, middle treble, everything is centered. I've got a little bit of delay and a little bit of reverb on, and the only thing I'm going to switch between is between the amp channels on the Boscatena, and of course show you some voicings of these Fishman Fluence pickups. So yeah, starting with a clean tone on the first voicing, everything full on, and I'm not going to do any post-processing on the computer. It's just, yeah, what you see is what you get, so to say. So let's see what we've got, and keep in mind, I haven't played guitar in ages. Nice warm tone. Let's switch to the second voicing. Yeah, real. Again, bright sounding single coil. Yeah, real difference between these 3 voicings. Let's put on a bit of crunch and see what we've got. Thank you.
Bit of a telly sound, isn't it? So let's switch to the lead channel for a bit more crunch. Let's add a bit of delay, reverb for some lead tones. And even a bit more drive. Let's see if she can do some metal as well. Wow. So yeah, these are the tones she can make, and I love these Fishman Fluence Classic pickups. They really have a classic feel and tone to it, in my opinion. Yeah, and I can't wait to try the Toshi Obasan set that should be a bit more modern. So, and here's the other one, and yeah, although it's also a Sonya model, I decided to refer to this one as the Black Magician. And you might know that the name Sonya, given to this model, comes from a fantasy novel series by Trudy Canavan, and the first trilogy from the series is called Black Magician, so I thought it was very fitting to refer to this one as the Black Magician. So yeah, let's go over some tones. Let's start with some cleans again. Neck pickup. Second voicing. Mm-hmm. bridge pickup. Also, once again, same as with the classic humbuckers, very different in the three voices. Let's add a bit of crunch. Up it a bit more.